Big trouble.
Bike, Big Trouble Podcast, and we purposely trying to get into some trouble.
This show is season.
I'm Ken Wynn.
Kevo the show, man.
We bike, episode 75. I ain't jumped the gun, huh? You 75?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Come on, man.
You
75. 75. We 3/4, man.
Yeah.
Come on, man. That's a quarter of each one. Quarter, shout out to Los.
Y'all already know, like, comment, subscribe. Every week we going up on every aspect of that. So we appreciate y'all for that, man, for sure. For sure.
Y'all know what time it is.
Yeah, off the rip.
Let's get right. Get right to it. This episode is brought to you by
Well, we starting out, what we doing? We starting out with
let's frame.
We starting out to the respond, the white boy.
Yo, my inherit the beef. Yeah, fuck all that pushing P. Let me see you push a T. You better hop spinning again on him. You think about pushing me. He's Terrence Thornton, I'm Terrence Crawford. Yeah, I'm whooping feet. We ain't gotta get personal, this a friendly fire.
I hate it when you stare. I hate your big dumb combat boots and the way you read my mind. I hate you so much it makes me sick. It even makes me rhyme. I hate it. I hate the way you're always right. I hate it when you lie. I hate it when you make me laugh. Even worse when you make me cry. I hate it when you're not around and the
Huh? He's running the white boy, huh? It was a lot of Kendrick slander, man. Kendrick taking too long, man. I don't know. It's a little too late.
Here we are, 3 episodes later.
Are we 3 or we 2?
Man, we 1 episode later, bro. I believe.
We just talked about this last year, right? Last week?
Yeah. No, that was 2 weeks ago.
That's 2 weeks ago.
Damn.
Just the 3rd episode.
My boy had to get in the lab and, you know, he'll.
Yeah, for that 6 minutes rap.
Yeah. That was I ain't gonna lie, I gotta dissect it more. I probably listened to it about 10 times. But it's
shit,
a lot.
Nah,
of, you listen to it every time.
I listened to it about 3 times. Nah, for real. I kept running it back. That mug hard.
Yeah, it took too damn long.
I gotta go.
Somebody called in between. I forgot all that to go back.
6 minutes.
Shit, nigga.
But that's crazy.
You know better than to do 6 minutes.
That's crazy how 6 minutes is a long time.
That's a long time now, bro. Yeah. But you know what I think about it? I didn't really start feeling it till about midway. Yeah. He started snapping. But that first part, he could have just cut that shit out.
I felt as soon as the beat changed. Once that beat changed, I was like, oh, yeah.
I mean, see, but it was like, I'm here.
Yeah,
now y'all starting to feel me. And then
I gave it to you like a story.
It kind of did play out like that, the introduction,
yeah,
the conclusion.
Yeah.
But around that midway, it was about a little bit before midway, but when he started snapping, I was like, oh, okay, yeah, this whole hill hit me. Because the first part, I'm just more like, nigga, get to the point. What the fuck is we doing? Like, what is this shit?
My boss say he's Terrence Crawford, he whooping feet. I know Kev felt. Yeah, you got that, huh?
That was hard, bro. I ain't gonna lie, that was hard.
Let me say this, bro. I'm not no biased nigga. I'm not gonna be biased because we know Drake coming back with something hard.
Hold on, that was the hardest line he got in
there? Nah, that wasn't the hardest line. It was a standout line. That wasn't the hardest line.
He had a bunch of hard lines.
What's the hardest line though?
I gotta see. I'm gonna think that YMW Melly line was hard.
I think that was the hardest line to me.
And then
that was hard too.
And then how he was just when he was breaking down. When he was shooting slugs at Drake Cat, nigga was saying, he was saying buku shit. And
see,
then,
that's what I want y'all, the difference is what I want y'all to know. When we talked about that Drake record, nigga, we damn near remember the song already.
Yeah, because it was.
Oh, yeah.
Because Drake, you know, Kendrick, bro, he always got to go a little deep, bro. He ain't have to.
Kendrick was sounding a little Eminem-ish.
Yeah, a little bit.
I like that.
When a nigga
say,
I like the flow.
I like the flow, bro. The flow is hard.
That make you just You ain't got no choice but to be like,
yeah, I'm on some 8 mile shit. It give me
like
8 mile.
That nigga
mile,
just, bro, he
then he responded like he was like, nah, nigga, Top ain't extorting me, nigga. When you come to LA, we gonna see who doing the extorting, nigga. Yeah. Nigga, y'all niggas think I got time? So y'all niggas think I sit up here and I'm in a boot all day? Nah, nigga, I'm raising my son. Something you not doing?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Nigga was coming at that nigga, bro.
Yeah, he was coming at niggas, show them niggas how you got your abs done, bro. Yeah, he came with all them niggas, bro. Everybody been on the white boy top about these surgeries. Yeah, and all this was going on behind the closed doors, man.
See, everybody knew he had that. Him
and Johnny Blaze when they did that shit together.
And French was right there with
French back bad build. I see he said went
that
away
shit, that yeah shit, that shit too long,
you gotta keep
how the hell you be flabby everywhere else but you just looking
you can't what the bro said, so you can't 25% body fat with the man. Like, you can see the outline, but you ain't just gonna have the whole total thing.
Drake bought the whole image, bro. He came with the braids long all of a sudden. After, nigga ain't go through no fro stage, bro. Like,
he went through that fro.
I ain't never seen him with a fro.
I ain't seen white boy do the fro.
Bro had that little scruffy. You know how he had that little miniature. Come on, man.
That was after he had the braids in, then he like let it pop out, but at first he had like a little something, and then he was braided up long. I'm like, yeah, okay.
What you saying? Weeded up?
I'm thinking. Come on. I'm thinking it's this whole
bro,
image.
He got white in him, bro. Come on.
Bro, he said this shit
going to say he going to bring Puff back, bro. He want to see Chubbs crash out. Because you always bringing up Chubbs. Now we want to see, hey, hey.
See, but Drake going to come back.
I want to see what,
because from what I heard, why J. Cole had that fight was because Puff was on Kendrick.
Yeah, he was on Kendrick's ad. But you know,
Kendrick was like, bro, I'm just 100. I'm too little, bro.
Nah.
Ah, that's what he going to say.
So J. Cole had to step up, and J. Cole got whooped. They thought Diddy was playing Diddy.
Diddy punched down on him.
I seen what's the name say that shit. You know Gene Deal. I hate that nigga.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Gene
Deal
was like, nah, Puff will fight your ass. He like, I ain't gonna lie, he ain't no hoe. He didn't fight, they didn't know how to fight.
I heard that too. I heard that.
That's why Puff be, and I tell all them little young niggas, he want to test their hands, bro.
Yeah.
He got a Drake though, dislocated his shoulder, punching, slapping the shit up, slapping Drake down.
Yeah, these, man, that's what I be saying, bro. Like, that boy Kendrick said, I like the melody Drake, not the gangster. Bro.
Not the nigga down, bro. Like, that's why I say, man. I'm not going to say Drake got to come back. Take your time, bro, because this nigga took his time. But when you do come back, I don't like niggas, but yeah, that shit was trash. No, it wasn't.
Nah, it wasn't trash.
Whatsoever, yeah. Them better be them biased fans, bro.
I don't like talking biased, niggas, man.
Yeah, they just pick, they chose their side and they stand there, bro. I'm being both ways, bro. That was a hard day.
I'm looking at it like this shit probably going to be good.
Yeah, it's about to be
good. That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Drake already got his shit wrote already. Yeah, I know he already, you know that drop. Yeah, that's already coming. Yeah,
intro.
Ooh. That's already coming.
I'm about to come soon. Yeah. Next week coming soon.
He gonna hug Drake.
Shut, nigga. Yeah, midget.
How this cool dude, that? Yeah, bro. That nigga the white boy.
That was.
I like that, bro. I like that.
Too. I like that.
I ain't seen no.
Because normally, like, I'm glad that he didn't wait this long and then come with some shit in it. And you just like,
he
could have
kept that.
I'm glad he came with some shit to make me be like, all right, Drake, what's up now?
Yeah.
Even though if it stopped right here, I'm good.
Yeah.
Like if they just stopped it right there, you got it.
Okay, they stopped it right now. Who won?
Drake.
Yeah, Drake won that too. Yeah. If they stopped it right now, be for real.
Yeah, for
but
sure.
But I'm saying if they did, I'm satisfied with it because it ain't like nobody got slaughtered or killed. You just got to be more like, he might have edged him.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
Then you got to factor in the wait time, and Drake came with doubles. He was shooting memes. He was active in this shit.
And once again, that diss on the radio.
Yeah.
I'm studying hearing it while I'm driving. I'm like, man, this nigga here, bro.
That drop and give me 50?
Drop and give me 50.
Push up. Oh, yeah.
My Jones streams went up.
It's on the radio.
Y'all seen that?
I ain't see that either.
Mike Jones said his streams went up like a motherfucker on that. That drop and give me 50.
I ain't see that. See, that's what
y'all don't even remember that was Mike Jones.
Yeah,
well,
drop and give me 50. Yeah. Heard him and Hurricane Chris.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't remember that.
So streams went up on the house. So Drake, once again, looked out for me.
Yeah. But I say, like, for the most part, the nigga Kendrick did so well, it made me forget that all them niggas was against Drake. Like, it made me forget about Kanye.
Really about him.
Yeah, Kanye did that whole shit, said that whole shit, and
I'm over it. See, what they don't realize is by them doing that, bro, it's just gonna make whatever Drake do 10 times harder, because it seems like he's fighting so many niggas and it's just him.
Yeah, but now that Drake can just focus on one nigga because he did his first. Yeah. Nigga, I had to hit Weekend, I had to hit
Future,
Metro.
But I didn't count Kendrick
Metro.
In that shit with them niggas.
Yeah.
I was waiting on Kendrick response, not what they all gonna say, what Future. Nah, I didn't give a fuck about what Ross had to say, for real. I was worried about what Kendrick, because that's what it really was about. He kind of gave the most bars to Kendrick. You knew it was about that. But I'm saying, as far as them niggas on that side, like the rest of them, when they fight against him, it's going to look better for him. Because it's like, oh, y'all piling up. And Kanye, you basically came out and confirmed it.
That you was a hater too.
And he like, I ain't even going to respond to this fat nigga.
Yeah, big boy trying
big
to
boy, he yeah, lost your yeah. mojo a little bit.
Big boy hate Drake so bad, it's ridiculous, bro.
Yeah, Drake been pushed. Drake been doing to him what Kendrick been doing to Drake. Just poking at him like for buku years and shit.
Mm-hmm.
I was laughing at that. What'd he say? What's that song he got? It was a regular song, but that fool was like, what he was talking about. Crap down the block,
made it right.
Made it right. I'm like, boy, that nigga be doing some old ass shit. Then only the nigga, he really doing it too. You don't know what he talking about now. I'm like, bro, that nigga, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. That nigga, oh boy. It's like, so basically, nigga, you just ride by my spot on purpose and shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Come on.
Hey, that nigga devious, bro. That's what I call Drake. I call Kendrick like a penman nigga, but I call Drake devious.
Drake a demon.
Cause it ain't
gonna. What I think?
Go ahead.
You know what I think about Drake? I think Drake knew that Kanye was hating on him for the longest, but he kind of looked up to that nigga, so he kind of was just more like, you know, how you be thinking you see some whole shit, and you be like, but that nigga kind of,
yeah.
You know what? I ain't gonna even mind. I don't know, but I think that's why when he did that Duffy and he was saying that shit. He kind of went into them bars and shit when he said, what he told that nigga?
He gave them bars to Kanye.
Yeah, and he was just like, father had to reach his hand out and get it from me.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? I was thinking about it.
I just came over there putting pen in the shit.
Yeah, but I was thinking, but I was like, how that nigga be doing them little clever lines? Because when they Kanye, I was listening to Kanye's song, it was like, their father. Stretch it. I was like, hey, bro, that nigga was putting some good.
Oh, yeah.
That 30 hours, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I pop star for 30 hours and let it repeat.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, bro, that nigga Kanye low key. And then when the Pusha T shit happened, that just took it over the top. Because he's like, damn, nigga.
Yeah.
You told that nigga that, okay, you really was waiting on this.
What the boy Kendrick said about Pusha T? About that Pusha T line? That was a hard Pusha T line.
He said, fuck Pusha P about Pusha T.
Yeah.
You slid on him?
Yeah.
He tan story. I'm tan crawl. Yeah, I'm whooping
That's
feet.
What the one here.
Yeah. That's what you talking about right there.
Okay.
Yeah, see, with the West Coast niggas, they feel like nobody fuck with them. You know what I'm saying? Nobody, they to they self. So these, when Kendrick came, they hype. I think this is why Drake never wanted to just like touch Kendrick, like, cause you know the whole coast gonna ride against you. If you, right, that's a big chunk of market right there, bro.
Yeah.
The West Coast is big,
right.
Nigga. You don't just got you got Arizona, you got what's Nevada too? That's
especially
gonna go with the West Coast.
Already, Game had already told them they were trying to line them up before.
Who?
Drake,
yeah, but that's why Game brought him in the hood. Game, you know when
fuck with him?
Nah, Game fuck with him tough.
Game know he always gonna get something.
You know when Drake did the
like Cash Money though.
Yeah.
So
when Drake did the 100 with him, he brung him to Kendrick Hood to diss him.
Oh, for real?
Oh,
he can look that shit up.
Oh, okay. Game was a
Game treatment. Was a whole nigga for
nah,
that.
Nah, I think Game just felt like, you know, Kendrick ain't pay dues.
Probably. Like, nigga, if I'm putting you on songs, I'm shouting your name out and you ain't show the same love back. Yeah. Cause like, he ain't never been on one of Kendrick Allen.
He never did nothing
together. And I think that, cause he said it on, I think he was on Vlad. He was like, Drake, my nigga, that's, you know, this what it is.
Been fucking with Drake for a minute, bro. I can say that.
Damn, bro. This would be a nail biter, bro. I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm ready to hear. But Drake already posted some shit on Instagram.
What'd he say?
He posted the shit with, that white girl, I forgot what movie it was.
Oh, yeah, I seen
that. I hate y'all. I hate the black boots you with your comeback boots. I hate the Jesus going on.
When he was talking about all that shit, he hated about that
nigga. Hated in a motherfucker.
Yeah, bro. He funny, bro.
White boy want to make memes. We ain't making memes, white boy.
We making memes.
White boy, we ain't making memes.
The memes help.
We rapping, white boy.
Yeah.
All that help, bro. Yeah. I like it.
He trying to take the Rick Ross route.
The Cameron route.
Yeah. So he know Kendrick ain't got that in his bag though.
Yeah,
that's the hell.
He know he ain't.
He ain't no funny nigga. Kind of like Drake, the pop star. So he can get more people on his side, like with his, with his little antics.
He funny, bro. I like that shit.
But I want y'all to go.
He had eaten for weeks. He said he ain't eaten for days.
He's on that. What he said he on that? What that medicine called?
I forgot.
He's just gonna say Ozempic. But if y'all, look, man, y'all gotta go to Kendrick, look up Kendrick Fenster, bro, before, cause he probably be posting some shit on there. We ain't just gonna.
Oh, that's where he on?
Yeah, he
oh,
be on okay, his Fenster okay. talking shit. Okay. He don't be on the regular thing.
He do his little shit. I seen him on that thing doing push ups.
Yeah.
So he do his little funny shit too, bro. He do his push ups. He know what he doing too, bro. He ain't just out the loop like that.
Mm-mm. But for now, I got it. 1-1. It's tied right now. At the end, I got Drake winning. I got Drake edging it by a little bit. Because Drake's song was like better than me. Right. Kendrick bars better, but I can jam Drake shit.
Yeah. I was just going to say, Kendrick shit ain't really got that playback value. Nah, Like Drake shit, I listen to at the gym.
They playing it on the radio, bro.
That's that hell kind of, it rocked like that, Like, even if he wasn't dissing and that hell was just a song, I'd be like, hey, this bitch going, like, you know?
Oh, man.
But.
They not going to like what I say this, but I'm blacks over Jews.
I'm biased.
I don't give a fuck. I ride with my niggas. Real talk, I ride with my niggas, bro. I'm not finna let this light skin.
He black Jewish, bro.
Mm-hmm.
He black.
But he just gonna put him in the Jewish category.
Yeah, he not black. We ain't gonna say he
black, bro. How you ain't gonna give him black? That nigga daddy's a nigga from Memphis.
Yeah.
How y'all take away from that, nigga?
Cause we talk about his mama too.
What
so
about
you
his
don't
mama?
Give him no credit because he grew up in the
white house. I ain't taking away his credit, but
I want to know how is the nigga not black? But all these yellow hoes is considered black.
What you mean?
You see a yellow nigga from Louisiana, nigga, motherfucking. Somewhere down, it's a Mexican grandfather or something
Stop
like that.
I'm going far down the line. We talking
well,
about.
Many yellows right now who got a Mexican mama or a white mama. We got a Mexican daddy or a black daddy. They a yellow bit and they are considered black.
But I think that's more so he's saying that Drake grew up in a white household.
He ain't say that.
I'm saying who more black.
It ain't about more.
It is. That's who I rock
black.
With.
I'm not.
You ride.
I am. I ride with the black mama, black daddy.
Instead black. Of the white Jewish mama and the black down south dad.
That's how I'm rocking. Let me rock how I rock. That's what I'm rocking with.
I'm about to look at your family tree, nigga, because you on the light skinned side, my nigga. You might not be straight.
My mama
black
and my daddy black.
Man, I'm rocking with you. That's all that matters. Nigga had grown fast in the motherfucker.
He had dread three times. Yeah. It was three times, nigga, had dread.
Don't make me take your hat off. His shit growing at a rapid rate. He better chill the fuck out.
White boy! It's your granddaddy.
His nose.
I'm talking about my
granddaddy. I heard through the grapevines, bro.
I seen him quiet over there, nigga.
I'm trying to get the room.
Nigga so black, just a black.
I said, so his mama white, not the daddy white. I'm trying to get the room, boy. I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'm rocking with my niggas, bro. I'm fuck with Drake though, bro. I can't.
Nah, Drake. The reason why I'm gonna go with I'm gonna show favoritism with Drake because Drake put H Time on. I'm sorry, like we gon' cause you see how I'm doing this.
I see what you're doing.
So the reason why I'm gonna say this is because the reason
he stole H Time swag.
Nah, he gave back to H Time too in a way. Where? Because he gave them weekends. He only had to stop because the city got so gentrified. I can't do the H-Town appreciation if it's not H-Town no more. But he was doing them weekends for like about a good 4 or 5 years, bro. And he was down here doing free shows. And he was down anytime he's showing love.
You know why he was doing them free shows.
Why?
Come on, bro.
Time.
Yeah, bro, come on. Man.
Do that free shit.
Yeah, that's my shit. That's they shit. He had to bust that night. They put him on, bro. He had to go.
I understand that, though, but nigga, Drake had a lot to do with our city being how it is, which is could be a bad thing if we look at it, the Houstonians, but it's the reason why we hot right now.
It's the reason why this city packed how it is because of him.
True.
Yeah,
I'm riding with Kendrick. Fuck white boy.
That's why the city on fire now. They thinking Drake gonna pop out.
He made a good point.
Yeah, bro. Drake is gone, Drake, bro. He not here no more, bro.
You remember?
He won the Katy, Texas. Drake, bro, get
they
your ass.
Already hot, bro.
Nah, get your ass out of here,
how
bro.
How long it take you to get home now, bro?
An hour.
Bro, Katy.
Used to be 25 minutes.
He just got a new spot, too.
And they study building out there. I'm, bro. Yep. I seen Drake's barbecue.
You remember Club Drake, bro?
Club Drake. Nah, that's
that was live.
That Club Drake was live.
He used to be up in there too. That wasn't
probably why I was live.
But he used to be up in there. Him and Chris Brown.
Now you see what I'm saying? Now they packed. They waiting on thinking he finna pop out at Club Drake. It was $50 to get in there. I remember. That was the first club that was hot in the bitch to get in.
It was farther to get in.
It was farther to get in. Yeah.
It was cheaper. It used to be some things up in there.
That was the first one that had the baddest in the man.
Who was with me when Diddy did the Super Bowl weekend? He added that whole little part to it, Club Drake. A whole little white. It was like a whole big, say for instance, like, you know how they do the football practice and they make that big round, like, I can't think of it.
You talking about like the tent?
Yeah, they make a big ass tent.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Diddy did that, man. I was popping that night.
There was somebody there. I can't remember.
I don't know. I probably would Jamal or something.
We done went to that bitch so many times, bro.
Yeah.
That Drake, though, boy. Whew. Man.
That was the one. Just put a nigga name on there, and
it was popping.
Yeah.
I seen so many.
Yeah, boy. Man.
I don't even want to talk about
that.
Speaking of H-Time, bro, we got some prevalent, some near and dear to us, man. They was. Sauce Walker, we start with him. You know, I'm gonna start. Which
nigga,
one?
The
I wanted to say.
Started.
Sauce Walker had to check a YouTube.
Where he came from? Like I said, we can go back to Jam Pony tapes. Come on, man. We need to get in contact with Ross, Trick Daddy. All, you know what I'm saying? All the Floridians, Trina, everybody need to chime in. Plies, everybody need to chime in. Because if you know the history of this state, it started in Tampa, then it started spreading other places. It's a fact.
I want to see like get Tampa told on the phone, man.
Not started in Tampa. I ain't going to say that. I'm going to say Lauderdale with Jam Pony.
I'm going to see like get Tampa told on the phone, man.
History and all the lineage. You know what I'm talking about? You spit me? Yeah, nigga. Now tell me I'm lying. R.P. DJ Screw, nigga. This shit is on our wall, nigga. This is a religion. Screw the world. This is our religion. You know what I'm saying? Salute the Tampa. I love y'all, but this is the last thing I'm going to say about it. Everything that we say in the Houston, Texas about screwed up music and slowed down music, we have the facts. Y'all talking about having slowed up music came. This man talking about slowed up music started in Florida and this day. Where is the DJ? Why are you not saying the DJ's name? You saying that it was happening during the 70s, during the early 90s out there, but you're not saying a specific person's name that the entire Florida can stand up and say, yeah, DJ so-and-so is the exact person that had us listening to slow down music in Tampa, Florida, or Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And if we're gonna really get into it, everybody know that Florida likes fast music. They listen to the music sped up. But they don't get it twisted. I have a large audience in Florida that love slow down music. I love Florida. It's my second favorite place to be in the world outside of New York. You know what I'm saying? Chicago too, my home. But
because a YouTuber got on there and said slow down music didn't originate from Screw. It originated from Florida. And he was like, you can go ask Trick Daddy. You can go ask Trina. Plies, bring them out. They'll tell you where it started from. So Sauce Walker had to get on there and do the due diligence. Take that nigga back to his history. And say, he gave me some knowledge. Like, and I ain't really start from Screw. It started from, I forgot what he said the dude's name was.
I seen it.
Yeah, then Killer got on there. And you had to say, like, nigga, I was there. I seen, you know, I seen Screw whipping it up.
Yeah.
Right in your face.
Yeah, he cooked it.
Ostrack.
Yeah,
Ostrack. My uncles now, they had it.
Yeah. The beeper number, the title, and the date on every tape. So when these niggas sitting up, if you are in the court of law, a motherfucker gonna sit up here and say you gotta have evidence to back up what it is you saying. That's cool. You can sit up here and say you did this shit all day. If it's on the radio, it's documented evidence that you did that. It's documented. You know what I'm saying? Because they record every radio show is.
You know how killer go get.
Yeah, y'all not finna take everything from a nigga, bro. Y'all not gonna take. Did they have slow back then in Florida? Did they have any?
No.
Because they could have had some underground
shit.
Like
he said, even if you did, the Florida niggas was out here and going back out there. So y'all first time hearing that, thinking that it came from that nigga, but he got it from this nigga.
Mm-hmm.
They like, well, nigga, why Rick Ross and them never said nothing?
Yeah,
because Rick Ross was down here.
He was down here.
With Tony Draper and them, he always talk about that.
Nigga with some paper.
Yeah, he was down here with them.
And Ross probably the one ran off and started that. You need to slow down the mixtape, some type shit. They stole that shit from here, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, you cooking.
They started.
Let me say that. You cooking. I want to elaborate on that point you just said because Ross was a fast rapper.
Yeah.
He was a.
Yeah. He was.
But when he got to the H, he came back. Call me Ricky Rose.
No,
and his voice was deeper.
It was.
So, nigga, you can't. Well, come on, man. Y'all.
Even Trick Daddy and all them. All them, that's what I'm saying. Where the slow rapping came from? What is they talking about? All
I thought Florida niggas was fast, too. That's what I thought.
What's the name shit? Y'all
even Plies used to be trying to cut out, put all them words in one sentence and shit.
I'll take you even deeper, bro. That's like Jay-Z. Jay-Z was a fast rapping ass nigga. Mm-hmm. He got down south. He started touching a little down south, started going to Virginia and deeper down south. Nigga came back with a grill and he was rapping slow.
When he got with Pimp C, he big, man. Yeah. He still was rapping a little fast on that.
Because Bun B was rapping fast too. Pimp C came in slow.
He slowed out.
But I'm saying Jay had a grill, bro.
He did.
And he started rapping slow. So this all the people that don't know Jay history, he took from down south, bro. Brung it back and start rapping slow. Sorry, that's just the facts.
Who is this YouTuber name? Let's expose this nigga, cause bro, they need to ban him.
He already to me, I was like, I just feel like it was clout.
Yes,
he knew niggas was gonna.
Niggas want to always pick on the H, bro, cause they know this bitch big.
This bitch popping.
Texas gonna ride.
So you just say anything.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
They're just like
JoJo just seen that nigga that said he walked in the thing and had seen Diddy and Carl Winslow.
Yeah, I seen that. Like, that was your boy.
Oh.
What's that Cali nigga name?
Bree Baby?
No, the nigga that been running his mouth by Shawnee. The one was with Wack.
Oh, you talking about
That was him, right?
Nah.
It wasn't him that said
that.
Nah, that was another nigga. This was just some
random
niggas. Yeah, but I'm that type of shit. I'm not gonna repost on my page and say nothing about it. Shit like that. I'm not gonna get that shit traction because that shit dumb.
Because I had seen that too, and he was like, I heard some shit moaning. I bust in. Why you just busting in there? And the nigga fucking.
Why was you there? You not invited, bro.
And why would you just bust in the room on Diddy fucking something? Like, come on, bro.
Nigga, you gay.
You not getting to know.
You want
to
see another nigga clapping cheeks?
Stop it, bro. Yeah.
Nah, he try to act like he just ran. But anyway, that can't get that type of shit no.
Yeah, let's
because know. When the nigga said that shit and I seen it, I didn't give it no play. But when they all gave it play, I said he got what he wanted. That's what niggas got to realize, bro. When you get that shit play, they got what they wanted. Whether it's true or not, they like got that nigga talking bit. Got him.
But. I just want to.
Bro, look, bro.
What happened? What you talking about?
I just put it. Diddy and Carl Winslow. It was him. Your boy.
I forgot that nigga.
Oh, that was him right there? Yeah. I thought it was the other nigga that said that shit.
No, it was him.
I don't trust none of he say no more.
I don't trust him, bro.
We wasted the episode talking about that bitch.
Yeah, loose lips.
We
called him loose lips.
He the one came in there saying that, bro. Now all of a sudden he just got in there and seen all type.
Nah,
he just got his clout going right now. He ran out of stories, bro.
But I want to I wanted to ask y'all, bro, since we here. First, I want to get your, what's your point of view on the situation? Because you never said how you feel about it.
About that shit?
Yeah.
Nigga, from my knowledge, Screw started it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's all about Screw, bro. I don't give a fuck about none of them other niggas. Like, niggas talking about niggas in the 80s and shit. If you wasn't there to see it, if it ain't no physical proof,
it
ain't
to be proof, bro. Fuck out of here with proof, that.
And he ain't got no name for it.
You gotta be proof.
Screw is named after Screw.
Screw would have had to been like, Screw, yeah, I got my game from bro over here. He kind of like, man, that shit ain't documented. I'm sorry, man. I can't get that shit
I feel the same.
Especially when the
you can say whatever you want and try to make that shit sound as smart as you want. You know, it was 1982 when what's the name was in the skating ring. How you know? Who told you that? Did you know? How do you know that that's true?
Especially when it makes sense when they say Screw was on that, or he was moving slow. It just sound like right, bro. Yeah. Like, come on, bro. It don't sound right about
that. They never, every time somebody do something, they swear to God somebody else did it first or whatever. Even if it was niggas doing it across the thing, but they never met. They probably never met each other or whatever. Mm-hmm. He the one made it famous and popularized it, bro.
Yeah.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because he started, you know how that nigga started with just damn near doing just whatever version of your album, he did it slow.
Yeah.
Then these niggas started like, man, hold on, we gonna jump on the hell, you slowing us down too and shit. Then it became that.
Yeah. Because it's probably true. That's why I say deep in Florida, they probably had somebody that was doing that, bro. But I don't think Screw stole that from him.
Hell no. And
did that, bro. Like, nah.
I just want to shout out Sauce Walker, bro, for preserving his Houston culture, bro. Because that nigga always putting his neck on the line. No Diddy, bro, for the Houston culture. That nigga gonna make sure, bro, anything said about Houston, I'm gonna say something about it, bro. And I got the history behind it.
Killer, not, too. Killer ain't gonna let you run around with no H-Time shit.
But Killer, more of an OG. Like, I expect that out of him. Sauce, a young nigga.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a young nigga that knowledgeable, bro. And he always jumping out there. Nobody really... This is the only time I seen niggas like, nah, we gotta jump behind a young nigga.
Yeah.
This time... Because you know, Sauce or anything, like, and y'all niggas weren't wearing jewelry.
Right.
We was wearing jewelry, then nobody get behind him. And you know what
but
I'm
you
saying?
See the,
right.
But you see the real OG niggas, they didn't even speak. Niggas like, I'm not even finna entertain Like, nigga, come on, bro. You not finna. Nigga, we screwed up click, nigga. We not finna entertain none of that shit. Yeah. Like,
it ain't worth it.
I wanna also ask y'all this, though. Speaking on the topic, I wanted to see what introduced y'all to the Screw shit. Like, what was the first, what the standout verse to you that you was like, a young nigga, you was like, oh yeah, I'm a Screwhead now. Like, it resonated. Like, damn, man, yeah. I gotta keep jabbing this shit.
You know, I'm back at Young House.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
You seen it with the.
Yeah.
You watched it out there.
He on the horn and wet. I'm in the Me and MC was
out there. Shout out to MC.
Nigga, you had to buy a line to come in the room and watch him do.
Youngster used to have people lined up in his house, bro. They found out where he stayed.
Yeah.
Yeah, they used to be over there waiting for the nigga.
Shout out to my T. Jones, though, because Young used to come get a 3 for $10, like 6 for $20. Yeah, you show Young. Young used to be telling nigga, stay in school. I'm bro, nigga,
shut
you
up, man.
You 16 nigga. Years old, bro, telling me to stay in school.
Not going to school.
For real.
Yeah, I'm going to give y'all more honor. I'm straight.
I'm good.
I don't know how to grab nigga.
My shit started from, you know, my fam from Sunnyside, bro. So my bro and them used to go
4519 Briscoe. Shout out to y'all.
Them boys used to go to Cullen and go to the Screw shop. And I used to stay seeing them great things. I never jammed them, bro. I used to see them niggas jamming that shit, but... I ain't get on it to like Don't Mess With Texas, Lil Kiki.
The Kiki freestyle?
Yeah. But even this the album, that's the first one that I heard slow down, bro. They had like a little Screw tape.
Oh, you talking about the real album?
The real Kiki album, Don't Mess With Texas. And I heard that joint slow down. I'm like, man, yeah.
Nah, man, I heard right that. Up. When I heard that, Young, because we from the West. So yeah. Young I always
but
gonna
young,
be.
But Young didn't. I didn't. Well, I was.
What?
Bud used to. Bud started
when young.
I was. Yeah.
He's young.
Yeah.
Oh, young.
Bud used to always have a Screw tape in his.
Yeah.
Remember that nigga's riding the nigga out of Toyota Tercel. That nigga, and that was a stick. He used to ride around with a screw tape bumping out. He had everything screwed
Slim
up.
Nigga clean.
Yeah, that nigga should be fresh in the clean, bed, bro. Dog. That
it was something about them stick shifts too, bro. Yeah. That just made a nigga feel like he was riding. My daddy used to have them stick. We riding. I'm just study hitting that on.
You still,
yeah, he didn't look so cool. Why you doing that, bro?
I actually want to know why is this nigga doing that?
Then yeah. They seemed like they just was cool. They whipped like this. Yeah. Hey.
I used to say, man, that how you doing it? You a learning once what nigga study hitting that on, bro.
Yeah.
Bro ain't grinding the other day.
Blowing that bitch, bro.
Couple, oh, yeah, he getting the good.
Hey, man, this shit go bad.
Yeah, Bud put me on that. Bud put me on. Well, this when I first heard
but
it.
What song?
But when I got, man, this was a long time ago, bro. So
it had
like
to be that pop every, in the rook, set, turn up, look, like.
Man, I think that's the for South me, like, at the, I think at the age that. Which one, nigga? Yeah, that is. That might be the one that I can remember myself getting on. But with him, I knew about Screw because everything he had in the car was screwed up. I don't give a fuck if that nigga was listening to 8-Ball and MJG.
Yeah.
It was screwed.
You ain't have no choice back then. Right. Man, my stepdaddy was screwhead. Like, you gonna have to listen to Screw, bro.
You had to listen to Screw.
I ain't gonna lie, my first Screw, bro, was the... Remember that?
Which one?
I forgot who the fuck that was, bro, but that shit stuck with me for a long time.
I'm trying to see what you talking about.
Damn, I can't.
You got to look that up after the poll.
Yeah, I got to look that
and
up.
See, but I remember mine was that BB Boys, what you with? I've been looking for your ass since the quarter past.
Yeah.
In my crib because you know a nigga real. Back to the because I got skills.
Yeah.
Going so long, I'm in the zone and I'm sitting. Hey.
That's that,
I just remember that BB Boy.
What
did
that nigga say? We used to rap that, man. We used to rap that bitch all the time. Damn, my bad. I didn't call my sister today. No, because we used to rap that bitch all the time.
Black leather, watch your cable in the crib, because you know a nigga.
Yeah, that's the
one.
I remember we used to... But I think that one I got on to that one from Gut. Gut and Papa used to jam that hole all the time. My cousin Gut and Papa, they used to jam that all the time.
When then I heard that though,
I remember that Gross McBee.
Black leather watch.
Yeah, I remember that.
That's that 3 in the morning freestyle. I think it's called 3 in the morning.
Yeah.
Shout out to my nigga Run D too, bro.
Oh man, Run, bro.
Run is the nigga that put me on the slow jam Screw.
Yeah.
When you jamming some, just say Anita Baker slow down, you know he gonna be singing and he gonna woo. That's the one. I'm like, hey, this is more jamming, bro. This the real Screw right here, bro. Yeah. He gonna put you on the real Screw, bro. I'm like, hey, Run the motherfucker.
Run used to come through with that bitch on them swangers, bro.
Yeah.
And he did that nigga Trump beating like a hoe, bro. He just screwed business. You like, man.
On that all like a motherfucker. Bro, he come, he hotter than the bitch.
H-Time nigga back then, man. I was just
Run had everything.
I was just telling somebody about that shit. I said, bro, Run was a nigga you was finna see. That nigga was gonna come. He was gonna have his slab. That bitch was gonna keep him a live ass watch. Byzantine.
With the piece.
With the piece.
Ice in my
nigga,
whatever was
in style, and he gonna have a frame.
Whatever was in style, he was in style.
He had it, bro. Yeah.
Iceberg. Yeah. When he went through all of them. That, I'm like this nigga. Yeah, he was
Platinum
the one.
Fubu. Yeah, he was everything.
You want the definition of H-Time.
And that bitch had a nasty, he had a nasty grill all
you want
time,
the definition
bro.
Of H-Time, it was wrong, bro. Yeah.
See, that if you're not from H-Time, we speaking of, this was the golden years, like niggas like Run, like we speaking on, this was classic, this come from Screw. Everybody that was a screwed up clique dressed like how Run dressed. We all had the bald fades.
Yeah.
Even if you-
At a certain point in time, for sure.
You had to get a bald fade,
You had
bro.
To, bro. That was it.
And you had to go to school, apple slap. Okay.
Cause you know we had Young niggas Flex.
I ain't gonna lie, bro.
Young Flex, they said the trend around all shit too.
But we gotta be in the group. Y'all think what's the most classic one though? Now, I don't know what put it on, but what's the most classic
Screw
that you remember?
June 27,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pokey and Young smashed that.
Yeah. Young told that bitch.
Yeah. Cause I was gonna say Young, but Podine, bruh. And Mo just, Mo was like a host.
Yeah.
Mo was young,
yeah, and bringing everybody in. That's what I'm saying.
That was
classical shit, bro.
That
was classical shit.
We gotta give Mo.
It's all screwed, too.
Mo gotta get Mo credit. This boy freestyle. He freestyled a verse. Niggas freestyle. They was freestyle, but going to bring. Nigga, you gotta know a nigga name, where he from.
Yeah.
How you coming down, bro?
That boy Poyo from the Yellowstone. Yeah, he gonna do some shit, That boy was hard.
Yeah, Young came in and did some shit. Him and Pokey, man, them was some
class.
Yeah. That's why I like when you talking about, like, you gotta understand, because if somebody really listen to this shit, they gonna be like, man, this shit ain't really making no sense. What them niggas saying? But if you was during that time, you know for a fact. This ain't no think of no bars, go in there and rap.
Yeah.
This is everything that come to your head right now, you spitting that bitch right up out your mouth.
Right.
Balls, nigga, like you going.
That's a fact.
That's you straight going. If you fuck up, you got to just keep going. Yeah. You got to keep. It ain't no stop, man. Hey, hold up, turn that.
And them bars barely, rarely fucked up.
Yeah.
Don Key, all them niggas, they barely fucked up.
Flipper be rapping and tell you he fucked up. Yeah. I'm gonna fucked up, but nigga, I'm the king. Well, that nigga, man say, bro, let me get it to the Houston Flip rap,
just
bro.
Took it, but I'm gonna say it like this, though. We even had Fat Pat.
Nigga, Fat Pat was a magician.
Fat Pat was my number one for
man, Fat Pat was. Bro, when I first started rapping, my whole rap pattern was like Fat Pat.
Yeah.
Nigga, I still remember the verse.
Yeah.
I'm a rapper to y'all at the
beginning. I'm sitting there with a couch.
Let me tell you something for real, bro. Like, a bunch of my favorite rappers is always niggas that talk like flashy shit.
Fly talk
shit. It be like Ross. Who else I got that talk flashy fly shit, bro? Ross.
Flip. You trying to get the flip? But, get to him.
Flip kind of feeling
Flip
my,
was the first flashy.
Flip
nigga.
Was talking about some. He was on some fly shit too. Yeah,
by the
he car. Was.
By the house.
No, he was. Come on, man. He was.
Stop playing with that man.
But, I'm just saying. Biggie was one of my fly, like talking just fast and fly shit. Yeah. You be like, ooh, that nigga talking some shit. Then, like I say, Fat Pat, bro. Oh, he was one of the first. Like,
but you know he was getting respected by Big now. All the way in New York.
He had to, bro. This nigga was saying some shit way back then.
Pat was the nigga who kind of birthed all this shit.
Yeah, he birthed T.T. All them niggas got that flow.
Pat should be getting the same kind of respect that Pat was down there like the Tupac of Houston, bro. Man, that nigga Pat need to be getting some of the, like, with Screw High Screw got. Pat need that, bro. Pat had a lot of lingo, a lot of, man, that nigga.
Way back then, like, bro. Yeah.
His flow pattern was just so special, bro. He was in and out of pockets, bro.
That nigga was, bro, he was digging in the pockets,
he was ahead of his time.
That nigga freestyling, then that nigga put that pen on that paper. When he put that pen to that paper, man, that nigga wordplay and shit and vocabulary was like, man, that nigga, that's good.
Then it was like, fuck, back then, it was fuck Swangers. He talking Big Body Benz.
Yeah.
SL Coupe type shit. I'm like, this nigga different level type shit.
That why you peeping me, bro. That was, hey.
Man, so.
Oh, that why you peeping me. Yeah.
And I like how, it was crazy because I like how when that boy passed, man, that nigga Hawk came with the bro. Hey, I was like, took the torch, damn, nigga.
Hawk just, hey,
bro, he was another animal, too, boy. Hawk was an animal.
And Hawk was a little more articulate.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He knew how to put it, you know, to. He's I was guy. Like, man, to where it wasn't just like, you know, Pat was H-Time. Nigga, Hawk could have went anywhere with this. Pat could have, too, but what I'm saying is, you know, when you hear Pat, you knew he was huge. Hawk kind of was like, swagging that hoe, you like, man, that nigga.
He'll tell you too, straight out of town, spitting verbs and nouns.
You know,
bro, this nigga got some lingo behind this shit for real. He got a degree behind this hood,
that nigga college education. You know, but a lot of people don't know the story that Pat really put him through college.
I'm gonna say Pat had a 4.5 GPA.
He Fat really had a 4.5 GPA.
Pat put Hawk through college.
They say every time when they came to school out, Pat was reading the book.
He didn't want to rap. He was just reading. Come on.
But I don't want to get off the subject until I got to get Lil O some credit.
I was just going to say that. Yeah. I swear to God. Because when we start talking about being articulate and vocabulary, even with that flow pattern and that nigga, Lil O was, he was in that.
For sure.
Yeah. He was in that.
O had, and you niggas like D Flowers, what's the nigga name? Big nigga from A League 2. D Flowers,
Max O'Cream.
All you African niggas that's on y'all rapping, bro. Y'all gotta pay. Y'all gotta start showing love to O, bro, because O opened up the door for them boys, bro. O was the first African, bro, that we accepted, like.
But we didn't even know O was an African, bro.
I knew he was African.
Yeah, I knew it, but I'm just saying, just off the rip. Yeah, well, how you get that bread?
African nigga.
Yeah. He's still on right now. Yeah, he African.
But they know they seen O and was like, we can do it. We seen Lil O. Lil O was hard, like Lil O was standing
up. Bro,
think about it.
Nah, bro.
You gotta see somebody that look like
you. You act like them niggas ain't just black niggas. Nobody cared about
that. Even back then, O was like, he was Southside fan.
Nobody ever said that African nigga made it. He was a nigga.
Peep what I'm saying, though. Y'all not gonna know. But to the African eye, they knew he was an African, bro.
What's that other African name that blew up by the A-League? He the top motherfucker.
That's Maxo.
No.
Another African.
Nigga that be, he studied popping out all the kids and shit.
He popping out all the kids.
Damn, bro.
I don't know. This
is time nigga from A-League, bro.
He got a bunch of kids?
Fuck, man.
Daniel Gibson?
No, bro.
Ski Taste?
Y'all know this nigga, bro. But,
damn, I'm tripping.
Man. This nigga name at the top of my,
What's wrong with you, bro? See? Yeah, nah. That's why you trying to do the shit you was talking about, nigga.
Nah, y'all gotta cut it out, though, bro. What I'm saying is, once you see somebody of your same complexion, your same get down, they know, they see them features.
I know what you mean. But
and
I'm
then
saying,
you write in their section.
Toby.
Toby. Yeah.
So you trying to say Toby went to Lil Owens? Like,
I bet you I can look up an interview he gonna say he influenced by Lil O. He seen Lil O do it. I bet you in the comment.
You already seen it.
I did.
Nigga, nigga. Yeah, but Lil O was hard, bro. I can't say.
I did, dog.
I'm gonna get a free dub.
Yeah.
Nigga, bet it right now. The video was already there. Nigga, look.
He went straight to it. Because the old album in my top five. Fat Rat with the Cheese. That's in my top five.
You talking about Houston?
I still remember that line. Used to play all of them.
We getting top five Houston together? Or what?
Top five Houston. What? Albums?
Artists or albums?
Oh.
Cause we did artists.
We did artists.
I mean, that Fat Rat up enough for me too.
I don't think I wanna
put TYP up in there though.
I was just finna ask y'all,
TYP wasn't no fool. The whole album wasn't like that.
It wasn't hidden.
But the bangers on there was bangers on there. But
no, what was his first album?
TYP.
It was.
No.
Throw Your Player.
Yeah. But you know, Zero got a harder album than him out of Straight Profit. Zero had a harder album than Young, bro. He wasn't commercially.
What was the album?
I can't think of the album.
But what I'm saying is they're knocking pictures off the wall. The single.
That was Change the Game.
That's top.
That was one of the.
That was nationwide.
That's one of the hardest songs
coming out of bro. That's true. Single wise, for sure.
Single wise.
But so you got Fat right up in there. What else you putting up in there?
Man, you know what else was harder than? Man, I hate to say this, bro. Flex. But Flex.
Yeah.
What was the badass?
Time to Play.
Time to Play was harder than TYP.
It was.
Time to Play was front to back.
Yeah.
That hold on, get the love, bro. It really was front to back.
The other one was hard too. The one with Pooba and them on there. Which TYP was that? That was like a put together.
That was the part. You talking like the part two?
That was that screen. Yeah. That was hard. That was a hard little.
Like the rain, nigga.
Yeah.
Like
the rain. That wasn't harder than that on that Time to Play with that Robert Conley on there. Ride on choppers
with your lady leg. Yeah, with these chickens every day.
Hey, Straight Profit had a hard little run. Yeah, they ain't get the recognition they needed, bro. But Then was what was it? They had Grace.
Grace was holding on too.
They had some good little shit, bro.
They had my boy Robert Conley. Martin Conley, MC.
MC was moving shit.
MC had boys on.
They had Pooba. Pooba was hard back then to be a young nigga, bro. I ain't gonna lie. That nigga was hard.
He was tough.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna put that Fat Rat up in there, and I'm gonna go. I gotta get motion credit. I gotta go see this, sir.
Bro, City of Serb had a nigga in the chokehold for about a good two years, bro.
Longer than that.
Longer than that.
You go back and play City of Serb right now.
Right now. Stepped in. I knocked down twins. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Hey, that nigga was so groovy.
Yeah, that was that's top five.
Man, I'm going 2000 Dope Gang.
Podine?
For sure.
Yes.
Yeah. Top five.
Yes, because I think that was better than Hardest Pit in the
Hardest Pit in the
Ooh. I don't know, see.
Yeah, I'm going 2000 Dope Gang.
Hardest Pit in the Little 2000 Dope Gang.
2000 Dope Gang, his delivery was better. I think Hardest Pit got a better song. Yeah, he was spitting that shit.
So we go Hardest
Pit. When Ward started getting on his album?
Chris Ward was on
2000 Dope Gang. He's on 2000 Dope Gang? Yeah, I'm going 2000 Dope. I was like Chris Ward.
That's when he
started
bringing all them Yellowstone. Them balls was hard, too.
That wasn't that one that keep my name
out your mind. You know my name. Yeah, I'm in your bitch driveway.
He was getting himself ready to go. He was getting himself ready to get out there.
What happened with these guys, bro? Because all these niggas had fire shit, and then it's just like...
These niggas wasn't business minded like that, bro. They were just talented.
Them niggas was full of their serious.
They was on that all, bro.
Them boys locked down. They didn't really did care. Because you got to think about it. They was making so much money.
So you got to think about Texas Houston is circuit, Houston is, bro. Yeah. Houston
that
is
Texas,
like that.
Louisiana, yeah. Mississippi, all that.
That down south, yeah.
Nigga,
yeah.
They was good with
they
just that
shit.
They
was going all the way to El Paso with it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nigga, they probably with niggas sliding over a little bit to New Mexico. But all that little down south shit.
Yeah.
Nigga,
Oklahoma.
They was eating. Them niggas was already six-figure niggas off that shit.
Mm-hmm. It was millionaire.
I know, but I'm just saying, you could have, on your bad year, bro, you at least going to make 300, 400, 500,000, bro.
You remember, I'm going to tell y'all, boy, see, we can get this. We can go all day for day for this. You remember EFG and Slim Thug, Boss Hog, got
they made paper off of that shit.
You made me think, because you know EFG had said no, it was 30,000 the first month.
That's why I say they had took it to another level. They made money off of that shit.
Hey, what I want, what I'm buying my truck. Hey, Slim used to be rapping his ass off back then, bro.
Yeah.
Man, that nigga Slim used to be.
I don't know why
he used to be flipping them balls. Nigga, I used to be like, hey, I used to like when I heard Slim Thug on the hell, bro. That nigga used to be delivering like a motherfucker.
So what else y'all put up in there, though?
That's three right there. We already put
2000 Dope Gang.
Man, bro, City of Serb. I got a Leprechaun, bro.
Every day we ballin'.
Man, Leprechaun was front to back.
It was more mainstream to me though.
That was here. Only thing about with Lil Flip is Lil Flip, he was rapping different from them boys. Yeah, he was already younger than them, so he already took what they did, but then he put his own twist on it. So that's why when Flip came, Flip was able to freestyle a little more clearer than them boys. Flip didn't do all that I done came down shit.
Hell no.
Flip was just rapping all the way through.
We do niggas like Checkers and they ass to get jumped. I'm like, this nigga spitting punchlines.
Yeah. Punchlines, that nigga was, man.
I gotta see.
Y'all don't want to put, well, just put Leprechaun to the side. And if you,
yeah, that's why like I said, I gotta see if I can put something above
that. We gonna
put
Leprechaun to the side, then I wanna put that Get Your Mind Correct to the side. Them two I'm gonna put to the side. So let's see what we can come up with before that. Cause I think y'all trying to go before them niggas even came out top five.
I don't know. I for some reason, bro, that flip just so mainstream.
Yeah, Leprechaun ain't sticking with me like it was cold, bro, but it's not.
Nigga, we want sticking with me. Cause the thing is,
it ain't sticking with me.
By the time Flip came out, we kind of want to be like Flip, like the jury and nigga. We gonna go get headbands and shit. When them niggas SUC was, we was just listening.
No, because this is what I'm telling you. The same shit that I'm saying.
You never wanted to be like Pokey.
No, I didn't see Pokey.
Yeah.
You didn't see these niggas. Like, by the time Flip came, it was camcorders and shit. Flip started doing the shit a little bit different. He kind of like perfected this. And Flip, like, it's going to be a visual to this freestyle. Mm-hmm. I'm going to show y'all me on the way to the Cap.
We're and the band. And this to the Cap on four swingers.
I'm going to put out videos to most of all a bunch of shows. You was able to see Lil Flip more.
I want the prime co-phone in there.
Come on, man. With 3 million minutes?
Yeah.
Come on. Nigga, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, Flip is a big staple in Houston,
If it ain't, Flip had to get an honorable mention if he don't make it, for sure. But I don't know why I put...
I just want to see what's the other two we finna put.
I'm going to put, to me, I'm going to go Kiki.
I'm going to say, I kind of feel what he's saying. We trying to go before Flip. Because my shit going back too. I gotta put a Kiki out.
I'm going Kiki Platinum in the Ghetto. Ooh. That was harder
that's
than
after that's after Leprechaun.
Yeah. That Platinum in the Ghetto was hard too.
Platinum in the Ghetto was hard. That's that was his best.
What's
album,
that one
nigga?
With
That was the mainstream, if you really wanna keep it real.
Platinum in Ghetto,
man. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You nigga, that was mainstream.
I'm going Don't Mess With Texas. That's my
I like Don't Mess With Texas.
That's my number class. One. That's my classic.
What's the one with when Flip run
you
Shasta.
Put no Don't Mess With Texas?
Yeah, that's my top five, bro. That's what started me on like, hey, I'm fucking with H-Time.
Yeah, I get all that, but that ain't what we doing.
Yeah, bro.
That's your favorite. I'm saying you really think that's a top five over...
That's my top five, bro, yes.
So when you present the culture, you saying, like, if I'm presenting culture to a nigga from Michigan or something, what's that? Yeah, I got to put Flip up in there. Because I'm going to want them to know about Flip. Because Flip is...
All right, but we still got one more. I mean, we had two more left. So you say...
Flipping Don't Mess With Texas is cool with me. Don't Mess With Texas. But
which one you put to the side with Chameleon on them?
Get Your Mind Correct.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, that's top five.
That's top, that's front and back. Him see, and Paul, when I'm putting the track together, I'm thinking about one that I put in and let that bitch play all the way through. And I'm like, bro, every song
Get Your Mind Correct and play.
I can rap every motherfucking song on this hoe with this bitch.
And then they need to see on that, like, hey, these niggas got some balls too.
Them niggas got, but that's why I had to try to throw the kind of evolved Houston in the mix too. Cause you know we had that, and it's kind of like,
That's why my Don't Mess With Texas is gonna be like number one. Like this is where it started. You need to hear like back then. This is how they started. Kiki was spitting some shit on that hoe.
Kiki was rapping.
And then it started started going up like
the
other shit.
Up.
Yeah,
in progress.
Get Your Mind Correct gonna be number five. Like
I'm cool with it being like number five and. Flip shit being like number four, and then we got the damn, but man.
So it'll be.
So we can't. Damn. It'll be. You know why? Me, I ain't gonna lie.
What you think of it?
But they ain't. I don't know if we count them as Houston.
Oh, UGK?
Yes, nigga.
I was thinking about that.
Nigga.
But I was thinking like, okay, we not really counting them as Houston.
You know, that's one album, bro, I had to get older to understand. Like,
which one?
The original, the Underground King.
Oh, nah.
I wasn't on that at a young age either.
Yeah, I had to get
I
went back when I was about 19.
And that pocket full of stones. This is the first shit
I bought my first key from my baby mama,
man.
Brother.
Yeah.
Bruh.
You had to, that's why I say, you had to realize, you had to be older to realize what the fuck was going on.
Cooked it up myself
and started. You know what caught me to that? Because that nigga Bug should play that pocket full of stones all the time, bro. We go ride around Fifth Ward. Man, what caught me to that was pimp voice.
Yeah.
And how he used to that swag and twang, say that. Yeah. I used to be like, man, that nigga there. I just like the way that
we ain't was. Say pimp. Pimp was honorary SUC though.
Yeah.
Yeah, he would. Pimp was my favorite down here.
Yeah.
Man, I learned that.
And that's who Sauce Walker is. He the new pimp.
Yeah.
For that generation, he the new pimp.
For that generation, facts.
Yeah.
To speak with his mind and say whatever they
the white girl up off the TV.
Start the white girl.
Yeah, I ain't.
My boy gonna say he doing
Pimp C has some crazy bro, shit, bro. I want to I love Pimp C too. He say,
but Pimp, he embodies. I got he embodies a overall Texas nigga. I'm talking about
when he be talking for sure.
When it comes to, I'm talking about overall him talented. When it comes to the way he talk, the way he rap, the way he can sing, produce, yeah. Nigga, that's all that's of Texas. Like, you go to them Dallas niggas, bro, them Dallas niggas, they was producing their tracks and rapping on them. You go to us, nigga, we spitting. Like, all around, he's a Texas nigga, bro.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, but you know how to think,
Pimp him.
A lot of the, some of them niggas was actually, like, a lot of them niggas produced that shit low-key. They just don't speak about it. Like, you ain't find out. A lot of niggas didn't know a lot of shit like that about Pimp C till later. Even Scarface.
Yeah, Face produced.
Face fuck too. Around. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because some of them niggas were DJs and shit first. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
But I'm just saying more so.
I know what you're talking about.
How rap stood
yeah,
out.
Yeah. But that nigga, Pimp C, he just, everything about that nigga, like, he was really the one.
Mm. He was. Like I said, you want to see nigga
to get old. Put that old school shit in there. That's why I fuck. It was groovy.
Yeah.
That nigga go get all them old songs from the 70s and 80s and change them up. Yeah. I'm like, nigga, that's I'm why, thinking that was that song. That's why P had to go fuck with him.
Damn, bro. But let's get to the last topic before we get up out of here, man.
What's the last one?
We on Mayweather and Tank.
Mayweather and Tank.
Tank told you what I told you. I'm glad hurt. I said it. Cause me and him going back and forth.
Is he still stuck in Dubai?
Tell Floyd to get on live. Tell him show where he at. You owe them people over in Dubai that money. Tell them to get on live right now. And he owe people in Saudi Arabia money too. Broken all here scamming people.
Oh, you fancy.
Tell them to get on live right now.
F-A-N-C-Y. Yeah, he's stuck over there. He owe them all $3 billion. He ain't never coming out.
He over there finessing Mayweather Promotions in debt in Dubai, bro.
Cause I'm telling
I ain't seen him come back and say nothing.
I seen his hair scrub in here.
His line going away. He need the plug in.
I ain't seen him post since. He always locked up in jail, bro.
He probably got a contract he signed.
Yeah, he got to do that.
You got to do a bunch of walkthroughs and shit until
fulfill
the contract. Right. Yeah. He gave the money up front.
Yeah,
that's true. They probably gave him about 12, 14 million.
He gave him some money, some big money.
Floyd stuck out there. They could have gave Floyd a bigger room. That room looked small at the end.
They put him in jail.
They dumbed him down. Ain't now. You gonna he miss. But I was telling C, I'm like, man, how I feel though. Just before Tank said anything, I'm like, I feel like Floyd is holding on to his prime. Like Floyd still want to be. I'm Floyd. I think that's why promotional wise. He don't get the shine because Floyd still be worrying about him. That's why De La Hoya like an asshole to his fighters, but De La Hoya be behind his fighters.
He stay out their way.
Yeah, but he stay out their way. I think Floyd, when I think about Floyd, I think Floyd be too busy for his own promotional shit. Floyd got fights over here, he be doing. He live, letting Ella be in charge. And that's how
he's
I feel.
Two of them niggas, he's supposed to. He still gotta eat.
But I think
he got more fighters.
But I feel like the fighter signed up because I want the fight on the floor. That's just like he just lost another one of his young fighters that had a good sparring with Tank. Tank gave him his credit. Mm-hmm. He just left because he was like, man, I want to be on the floor. It was a good opportunity, but they were slowing me down because Floyd, I think Floyd want to do his own thing. So I think that's why the young fighters coming up, like, man, Floyd be kind
of. So that's what I'm, this is, you want Floyd to sit there and hold your dick for you, bro? You already got the name attached. What fucking more do you need? I seen Tank get gay like that. He didn't even come to my fight. He had his own fight.
See?
Nigga.
Wait, what?
That's what he said. What they saying, that's how the young fighters feel.
He had his own fight.
Yeah, he had a fight around the same time Tank was for the fight. Yeah, exhibition.
So you mad at him because he went?
Yeah, gay shit is what I'm saying. Yeah, nah. These niggas be acting like hoes, bro.
Yeah, that's new age niggas, bro. Yeah,
these new niggas act like hoes.
Yeah.
See, I'm not speaking on that. I'm speaking on the fact that Floyd do a lot of.
I know what you're saying.
Like my prime example is like when he told Bud to go fight Benavidez. Like, bro, why would you try to? You want that nigga to get the L.
Get that L,
because niggas is really undefeated. Saying this is Terrence Crawford era.
Yeah.
So you like, man, nah, I don't like the way that's
not your fight.
Fight Benavidez.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, bro, why are you trying to set niggas up? Why are you so happy that Dev lost?
But damn, he called out Canelo.
Who? Canelo is, we the same height. You, if you gauge in that, bro, it's like, bro, Canelo about 5'8".
Yeah.
He just bigger than me.
Yeah.
But when you think of Benavidez like 6'1".
Crawford moved up, right?
Nah, he moved up 155.
He was going to move up to fight Canelo.
168.
How tall was Corrales?
Corrales, they was in the same weight, though.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying.
They ain't nobody had to move up.
I'm just saying how tall was.
He about 6'2". 6'7", but they same weight.
But you plan on moving up. I'm sure Benavidez will come down there and meet you.
Benavidez said he didn't want to meet. He was like, because the new fight they just did, the little prince from, I don't know where he from, he just offered Benavidez that fight with Terrence Crawford at 160. He was like, I can't make 160 at all.
Yeah, but if they was meeting somewhere, like, what I'm saying is if he was going to go up to fight Canelo at whatever weight they was going to fight at, and if bro meet him now, I don't see nothing wrong with the fight. But if you trying to tell a nigga to jump 2, 3, 4 weight classes to go fight a nigga, that's asshole shit.
But he did what he was telling him.
Yeah, nah, that's dumb.
But what I'm saying, that's the thing with, I don't think Floyd, the reason why I don't think Floyd want them niggas to touch his legacy. I don't think
the
he want nobody to go over.
The thing to remember is they not, even if nigga make it past 50, you got to look at what's done in the 50.
Yeah.
What's done in the 50s? None of these niggas is on the path to that. Because it don't even seem like it's that many motherfucking fighters that you can respect at whatever number these niggas finna go. Tell me right now, Crawford go to 50 and know who is in his way to compare the resume to be like, man, he kind of outdid Floyd on that. It ain't that many niggas.
Earl?
Not good. Earl, man. I'm saying after. Like
Earl,
now.
Ain't you have to get Canelo on there.
And that's a
nigga. But I don't even think he's gonna make it to 50. He probably make it like 44.
But that's because it's not enough niggas. And it's not enough good niggas.
For sure.
And then
that's all I'm saying.
Another thing about Floyd is Floyd don't understand this. Like, nigga, you was the best defensive fighter of all time.
Mm-hmm.
So, nigga, nobody can never touch that, period. Like, they gonna always say that about you. Like, Floyd was the moneymaker and he was the best defensive fighter of all time.
But what y'all failing to realize about Floyd, nigga, is Floyd was past all that shit, the nigga was better at promoting.
Yeah.
Why you think he put himself in shit? Oh, yeah, but he couldn't fuck with my bro. Floyd, no, he ain't gonna fight, but he do that just to make niggas be like, damn, boy, if they would have fought such a, he know what the fuck he be doing, bro. Yeah. That's why he always gonna throw himself in the mix. Mm-hmm. He gonna sell the fight, he gonna make you love him, hate him, whatever.
He's still doing that to this day.
He do that to this day, because that's how he get paid.
Yeah, he got it.
That's why I told you kind of like when the shit was going on, I'm like, bro, these niggas do this shit all the time. Right. When Tank finna fight, bro, they go back and forth.
I just don't like that, though, bro. I don't like, even if you not signed with me, bro. If Dev ain't, Bill's saying shit to you.
I know.
But if Dev ain't saying nothing to you, bro, let that man go. Let him alone, bro. Because if you want to really, if you get whooped, I really want to offer you some help.
That shit was funny, too. You seen when he broke down his fight? Nigga, look at him when you jab. You know what I'm
talking
about?
It was true.
What
I said on the pod before he even started talking.
He need a better trainer.
I said, bro, he's a poser.
Yeah.
He's jabbing like this.
He said he need to leave his daddy alone too and get a real.
But what I'm trying to figure out, if you know a nigga got a strong motherfucking left, why is this arm, this hand should be right there at all times, bro?
Because this is how Crawford was fighting Spence. Anytime he bagging up, he know you about to throw that bitch.
I don't give a fuck what I do. That bitch coming up.
But this comes with training, bro. He needs a better trainer.
He do. He do.
But my thing is this. I don't understand why you be saying.
Me?
Yeah. Like, man, even if I ain't with you, go grow your wing. Bro, you know it's promotion company against promotion company, right? Right. So why am I letting you be?
I ain't saying let you be. I'm not saying, like, nigga, I got to fuck with you. I'm just saying if you want to. I'm talking about, like, how you speak on it. You say, nigga, I'm with the black fighters always.
Right.
So when I look at Floyd, I'm like, bro, these young niggas coming up. Why you want to pull this coattail behind the scenes and be like, hey, bro, you got to get another train or something, nigga, besides my promotional company. You ain't hate. I'm saying any nigga that's not hating on you, and I don't feel like Dale was hating on you. Dale always gave Big Floyd his credit. Like, I started with Big Floyd. He the one, you know, gave me this, taught me this, taught me that. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, but you got it straight because your daddy, bro. And you gonna catch a bunch more because of your daddy. But my thing is this. That nigga Floyd was finna come in, how I look at it, and build a motherfucking elite alliance of black fighters. We all get up under this Mayweather umbrella, do y'all thing, and then y'all niggas can grow. No, them niggas wanted to be Floyd Mayweather.
Right.
Floyd telling these niggas, bro, I had to start off somewhere, bro. Yeah. I didn't just come in Mayweather promotion, nigga. Yeah. I had to get in, get right, do this. No, them niggas looked at it straight. That's why he be talking about, yeah, they getting this money and shit. Nah, they think everything good and then boom, boom, boom. No, it's not going to go that way.
I think that's
fucking he wanted Devin. He wanted Tank. Right. He wanted Crawford. He wanted all them niggas like, I'm finna build the golden boy, but it's gonna be for the black dude. Yeah. All them niggas want to go their own way.
Yeah.
So why do niggas think that this nigga still supposed to be walking around with some type of respect for them nigga? Man, fuck them niggas.
Yeah.
Nigga, we could have built something crazy, but if we reach off and do your thing.
I think it's a different game. Them niggas getting a lot of way more money. In 20 some fights, Floyd wasn't getting 15, 20 million.
It's Floyd game.
Yeah.
They see, cause Floyd broke it all down.
Yeah.
So now his own shit biting him in his ass.
Right.
That's true.
So now when you done, you trying to be like, oh, let me get. They looking like, no, nigga, we want what you got. Nigga, shit, you showed us a $100 million check.
But if you coming up.
And that's at 40-something fights, though, when I made it.
But no, it's when he got his own. He did his own promotion. He got on his own shit.
Oh, okay. I see what you
saying. So this is why they saying, instead of me getting under you, why don't I just do it myself?
Yeah. I mean, I understand that, bro, but I just would have stuck with the Floyd route, bro. To me,
I would have went with. I would have did it like Tank. Yeah. Started with you, built my shit up, and then be like, "Hey, the contract up.
Yeah,
my name big. I'm finna go my own way." Because you always got that nigga in the pocket. Him and Tank, him and Floyd gonna be right back cool. Watch.
Yeah, I'm sure, bro. I'm sure.
But my thing is this though. If these young niggas coming up and they praising you. And you saying shit, I'm only speaking, I don't like the Dale shit, bro. And they're not even my fighter. They'll praise these niggas, bro. Like, I seen what Floyd did. I just seen his interview. I want to do what Floyd was doing. My daddy was already making street money, him and his partner. I was like, nah, I don't.
What do you mean doing what Floyd was doing?
Like he want the cars, he want the work.
Yeah, I seen his house and shit. All his shit was already plush. He got the Floyd life. Devin,
he was saying when he was coming up, he was looking at Floyd.
Oh, okay.
He was like, he wanted to do it. He seen Floyd, you know, running and working hard. He was like, he got all that shit from Floyd. So that's why I'm saying, like,
Floyd didn't really criticize him, though. He criticized his dad. Think about it. Yeah. He said,
that's true.
Oh, nigga, you needed my help the other motherfucking night. Then he talking about how Dale, you got him going in there like that?
Yeah.
He ain't really say nothing bad about Dale.
Dale right open. But I'm just saying, nigga, I'm going to pull your coattail behind the scene. Now, I don't want to come with you. Nigga, you said that shit in the public. I don't want to come to you for help.
You got to think about this, too, though. Floyd wasn't on. So many niggas came at Bill. It was Bill, this shit.
Yeah,
live, bro. Ran Bill a lot of niggas out. Yeah. But he'll, you know. That's why everybody was like, oh, yeah. That nigga did. Brona.
Yeah. Brona got hired at him.
Nigga, y'all got to come see me now, bro. Like, because you did that, bro. Mm-hmm. You did that. Devin could have took a respectable L and everybody wouldn't have, but your mouth, bro.
I think Dale will bounce.
Cause back. I don't take nothing away from Dale for that loss. Not me. I don't.
The nigga came.
Man, dog.
I don't. Bro, he didn't get slapped.
He got jaw 5 times,
it
bro.
It don't matter. It only counted as 3.
Man, dog.
I don't take that from him, bro. I ain't lying. I don't take
that nigga on some bullshit, bro. I'm stop it, bro. So, so
that was a beating kill, is what you said? Because you said the category. He was like,
he didn't get, that wasn't a win, loss,
or a
beating. I'm not going to give it a beating because every drop was like a one punch.
So,
drop,
so but now, still, so how I'm tripping then?
No, but you got to take something from it. Like, you got to drop 5 times, bro.
No, I'm not stop saying that, that way. No, I'm not saying it that way.
You're going to take something from him,
what
bro.
What I mean is, he lost. I'll see, I'm going to watch the next Devin fight.
Right. I want to see what he do, too.
When he fight who?
Whoever.
He gonna have to fight a tune-up.
He gotta go get Rollie.
Who? He gotta fight a tune-up.
He gotta roll it.
Rollie, tune-up.
Rollie might knock that hoe.
I was
Rollie strong. He might get that old chin. He gonna
in
be
the back of my mind. Yeah. I'm taking that. I'm Rollie.
But Rollie, Rollie was touching the round this morning.
That's what I'm saying. Nah, bro.
Nah, he needed. He need, yeah, he need.
I want to see the next Ryan fight. I'm looking toward the next Ryan fight. Before,
See, but now Ryan getting the grid like he deserved it, bro. He got knocked out.
He got body shot.
He got knocked out. You got dropped in the second round, and then you gave up. You didn't get up no more, bro.
But that was a body shot.
I don't give a fuck what kind of quit. They'll fought to the end. I don't give a fuck how many times you got dropped.
They should have had that weight clause up in there.
All right, so who looked better, a nigga that lost to an undefeated nigga or a nigga that lost to a nigga that got dropped by an undefeated nigga and you got dropped 5 times by him? You in fifth place, bro.
Yeah, you put Devin under Shakur.
Under Shakur now. God. Shakur undefeated, bro, and he never got dropped 5 times. He's
Shakur
over
ain't
you.
Fought nobody, man.
Man, whatever.
Now, Shakur looked the weakest fuck in that last fight, and he's still.
Everybody's style's different in
he's
boxing.
He's still at the bottom to me.
So it's Tank Ryan.
No.
You don't want to give Ryan.
It's Tank.
I'm not giving Ryan nothing for that, man.
Bro, he dropped him 5 times.
Ryan
he
got knocked out, bro. He just got knocked out.
It's TKO. See, come on, bro. It's don't still put a knockout. The knockout on there. It's
what,
TKO.
What TKO stand for?
Technical knockout.
He got knocked out.
It was a technical. It wasn't a KO.
It was
KO
a knockout.
Knockout.
Technical knockout. He got knocked out, bro. He quit.
So which one you would take? You would take, I'm going to ask you a question. You would take,
fight, like how would I,
how would lose? You lose? You
I'm going to die with my sword.
No.
I'm going to die with my sword.
Beat me, bullshit, bro.
Beat me, I'm going to get back.
So you would take out Spence, Wynn-Ite, or Ryan?
What you mean?
How Spence got his ass beat.
To 12.
All right. Yeah. You take it.
Drop me out on the six.
Yeah, drop me out with
drop
the
Drop me out with the
bottom. Okay, you brought Spence. I thought you were going to say David.
I'm going to
bro, drop you got beat and knocked out.
Yeah.
I can't take both, bro.
Who got beat and knocked out?
Spence.
That's TKO.
He said Spence.
Oh, okay.
I thought he was going. Okay. I thought he was going to say Ryan or Devin. I was going to say, give me the Devin, bro. I'll go up and fight
Spence,
to the
that's
end.
That's Spence supposed to got stopped, bro, early.
Man, Spence got beat to a pulp, bro.
He fought to 12, bro. You say fighting to 12, they'll give you something, bro. He fought to 12.
So, ooh. so
Spence?
Yeah.
Spence got
Spence
to 8.
Spence ain't going to 12.
Spence got the 8.
What you talking about?
They stopped it.
Nigga, Spence got the 8.
Oh, yeah, they did. Yeah. Wait, I'm thinking
about
it. He
got beat and
Yeah. I'm thinking about
it. That's why I said, I thought you were going to go to Devin Ryan. I said,
that's that type. I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, chill, bro.
That's that type of ass. But I want to ask y'all this, but we go, bro. We get out of here after this. We got a fight coming up, Canelo. And I forgot his name. Mangule or something.
What about?
I'm trying to see who y'all got.
Who is that dude? He Russian?
Nah, he Mexican.
Mexican dude.
I got seen his highlights.
I gotta look at his shit.
Crawford got a fight coming up too with a nigga that's 10-0.
But he like a little strong little Russian.
Man, we really finna get Crawford some
No, I'm not getting no credit for that.
That's what I'm saying. Crawford don't got nobody to fight, bro.
Yeah.
What do he need to do?
Man, he can't call nobody wanna fight that nigga, bro.
I wouldn't want to fight him either.
Yeah, he
got to say anything, bro. Hell nah.
I'm just saying, retire. What else you gonna do, bro? These niggas don't want to fight you.
Jermaine don't want to fight you.
Now all they want to do is a nigga 2-3 weight class want you to be like, hey, come up here and fight. He got the advantage.
Yeah,
that's why I respect Tank for the hydration clause on these niggas, bro. You not finna get all of that on me, bro. You not finna get all of that. You can't get that big. Have that height.
But
be that strong.
Tank be talking to Terrence though, like he just.
He just talking.
They all be talking shit to each other. Yeah.
He just talking.
What you mean? Like what?
He be talking tough. Like,
you saying, like he want that issue?
He said Tank. He said Tank got that glass jaw.
I think Tank.
He said, yeah, tap that jaw. He told that nigga, I'll tap your chin.
If Chance did not see that, if Chance come down,
nah,
he
might
get that chin. Yeah, that
we done seen. We done seen he got a little.
Yeah, seen him wobble.
We seen Tank got wobble, though. See, y'all only talking about that.
I ain't gonna say, I ain't never seen it either.
I seen Tank get hit with some shit, but I ain't never seen
a wobble.
All right, go back and look at Pitbull. He ain't got wobble, but he got stung, nigga.
Yeah,
like, he
got stung,
He was like, oh, shit, he had to wrap up, like.
But I ain't never seen that nigga legs just. He got a strong ass chin.
The way they been doing Haney, bro, they been doing Haney bad, bro. I'd be feeling sad for that nigga at a certain point.
But everybody knew Haney had that chin.
Even before that, I would just be like, damn, they doing, nigga had got caught by that nigga. They been doing them bad. Even at the end of that fight, he tried to act like he nigga tried to climb up
through.
We been said that, bro.
That nigga, he really wasn't. Yeah,
we been said. We know that, bro.
Ain't no we been said nothing, bro.
We all been said that, bro.
Nah. You not finna put that on everybody.
Then we all been say like, Haney cool.
I never said Haney cool.
Nigga. I just said cool, like he not.
I don't think Haney can beat nobody live, bro. No, nigga.
I said Haney was a beast. I'm not gonna lie.
B too.
But I did say his chin was suspect.
Yeah, I did say that.
But I always said like he not nothing spectacular. I never seen him like beat the shit out of a nigga, bro. Like,
he got boxer skills. He got skills to pay the bills, bro. I'm not taking that for
you. Yeah, he will. When you going on the point system, but he can hang with him.
He's a weight bully, though, bro. That's why you going to get that chin check, because you dropping down. You supposed to be at 147 already.
Yeah.
But you at 140. You trying to climb up. Nah, nigga, once you got that grown man strength, go up there and fight the grown man.
Them grown man gonna touch that chin. That chin is a different ball game.
That nigga still ain't hit puberty yet with them pillow punches.
Yeah, Lord.
But we gonna get up out of here. That's episode 75. We came back. Hey, drop in the, what my boy say? Like, comment, subscribe. We out, man.
We out of here.
And drop and give us 50.
Yeah.